God says, see, while you're looking at the fact that life has ended for those sin folk, he said, you can't see the blessing that's in this storm. Woo! Somebody said, what are you talking about, preacher? I'm talking about the survivors of that bus crash. Future to be blessed beyond this. You didn't see that coming. I'm talking about the 10 folk that died. I can just see the family now. They grieving real hard. But wait till the insurance company write the check. Woo! I said there is a blessing in the storm. You ain't gonna have to tell man one of them folks to give God praise. They gonna praise him anyhow. Somebody said that it was a bus full of disadvantaged children who may or may not ever get to go to college. They ain't got to worry about that no more. My brothers, brother, might go to college behind this blessing. See, the point I'm making is that storms are bad in the sense that it's tragic. But what you've got to realize and understand is that when bad, devastating storms hit your life, God is shaking some things loose. And the things that remain just need to be there. But when God gets through, and when the storm is over, and all of the dust settles, you are fixing to experience more than enough. God has his own way of blessing us. He said, if you give, it shall be given you. Good measures, pressed down, shaken together, and running over shall I cause men to give into your bosom. I find that after many storms, men become givers. Folk that ain't never gave a dime. Folks that ain't never cared about nothing. I find out that some storms bind families that's been broken back together, closely and tightly. I find out that some storms come and take folk vehicles and they drive new vehicles after driving old vehicles their whole life. I find that some storms come and take old houses and folk finally get their chance to live into a new house. I ain't asking you to pray for the storm, but what I'm asking you to do is that when God sends a storm, you ought to begin to give him a shoot of praise. Just begin to praise God in the midst of your storm. And remember all the way through that there is a blessing right in the storm. Some of you say, preacher, the stuff that I'm going through right now, I have never experienced such. Things are so difficult. Times are so hard. I'm struggling. I'm struggling more than you'll ever know. It's hard for me right now. I feel like throwing in the towel. I just don't even think some days I can make it. I just think I feel like giving up. I just want to throw in the towel. Don't you realize what I'm going through, man? Why are you up there hollering me to give God some praise? I can't seem to find the praise. But I want you to know something. The Bible said, they that trust in the Lord shall renew their strength. He said, they shall mount up on wings as an eagle. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and never faint. I beg you, trust in the Lord with all of thy heart and lean not unto thy own understanding, but in all of your ways acknowledge him, and he will. Look at your neighbor, say, he will direct your path. Yea, go along through the valley of the shadows of death.
I feel the rain. Come on, give the Lord a wave.
hands in here, give them a break.